Good morning sa lahat ng ating mga kasambahay. Magandang ating topic ngayong umaga. I don't know kung makaka-relate ka or makaka-relate ang iba nating mga kasama dito sa studio. Hindi lang dito sa loob ha, pati dito okay. Po sa buong UNTV. Anyway, pag-usapan natin mga kasambahay ang ADHD. Ayan, lagi na natin naririnig yan, ano? Siguro kasi talagang maganda ang campaign nila. At kulang na lang breakfast kasi grupo kami ngayon eh. Ayan, pang-apat ako. Makakasama natin ngayong umaga. Ang una, sino ba? Beauty muna or age? Beauty.
Beauty.
Ayan. Okay, unahin na natin ang nanay po ng dalawang bata na merong ADHD. Pababatiin na po namin sa inyo mga kasambahay si Miss Grace Santos. Good morning.
Good morning po sa kanila yan.
Parang wala siya. Okay, sunod naman natin ang age or beauty again? Again, ay.
Beauty pa rin.
Okay, unahin muna natin ang student po na meron ding ADHD. Very proud to be here para po tulungan kayo. Tayo, mga kasambahay, na mas lalong maintindihan ng sakit na ADHD, si Andrew
Dominic.
Hey, yan, okay. Napakagwapo. Good morning, Andrew.
Good morning.
23 years old pa lang po si Andrew.
And actually, 24.
Ah, 24 na. Opo. Kami nagpapabata. Ito talaga pagbata pa eh. Okay. Tatanong natin kung kasama yan dun sa mga karakteristik ng may ADHD, yung accuracy. Anyway, ang pangatlo po natin, ang nagtuturo po ang teacher at study coach ng ADHD Society of the Philippines. We're very proud to introduce to you Mr. John Fiel Meria. Good morning! Okay, pag-usapan na natin kaagad ang ADHD. Sino bang una? Siya muna, no? Kasi what is ADHD ang unang tanong?
So, ang tanong is, what is ADHD? So, it stands for Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, recently there was a revision in DSM-5 or Diagnostic Statistics Manual. Yung po yung ginagamit na manual ng mga doktor to diagnose ADHD.
Apo.
Basically, we're now able to diagnose adults as well, including children. So, there is such a thing as adult ADHD. Ano po siya? It's characterized po ng tatlong bagay.
Mm-hmm.
Ito pong hyperactivity, yung, you know, very energetic. Yeah, excessive energy and activity.
Yes.
Tapos you also have inattention to pong ano, difficulty to pay attention, to be organized. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then you have impulsivity, which is yung acting on impulse, blurting into, you know, people's conversations. So ito po yung ginagamit at tatlong characteristics ng doctors, ito po yung minimeasure nila to check for ADHD in children and adults.
Napapangiti kasi dito si Andrew Dominic.
Yeah.
Parang nakarelate siya. So yung tatlong nabanggiti doon, Mr. John, tatlo yun eh. Lahat ba yun naramdaman mo?
Well, actually, I'm the youngest of my three siblings.
Yes.
And in earlier literature, there would be three types of ADHD.
Yeah.
So, just to go past it all, I'm the combined type. So,
merong isa lang, hyperactive lang.
Yes. Merong hyperactive type, merong inattentive type, tapos merong combined type. Siya po yung combined type.
Okay, congratulations.
So,
100% test.
That's very hard. How about you, ma'am? Yung inyong pong two boys. How old are they anyway?
Si Luis is 10, okay. Yung youngest naman is 7, yung panganay yung merong ADHD.
Mm-hmm.
Luis is the inattentive type.
The inattentive.
No. Hindi siya masyadong malikot, pero yun, madaling madistract, mahirap mag-focus sa kahit mga simpleng mga bagay.
Okay, so, I know si Dominic, kasi Andrew Dominic is from UP.
Opo.
Aba, panalo.
Yeah.
Diba? Pag-usapan natin yung characteristic kasi yung tatlong nabanggit mo medyo hindi masyadong maganda. Hyperactive, although hyperactive is nice naman din, wag lang in excess. Pero isa-isahin natin, aside from the yung tatlong nabigay mo, may mga positive attributes ba rin naman ang isang taong may ADHD? Kasi ang isang nagiging problema nila yung acceptance yung pagkilala na merong ADHD. Sinasabi nila kasi ako, my experience, no? Hindi naniniwala yung tatay ng anak ko na may ADHD. Ayan, in-announce ko na.
Wow,
I'm very proud to say kasi he's very sweet and he's very intelligent, my eldest. But he was diagnosed with ADD. Ang naging problema namin, ayaw tanggapin ng tatay. Siya ay in denial. May mga ganun bang...
Oh, definitely.
Kasi diba, gusto ko marinig yung mga positive attributes din nila.
Well, at least two things, no? Usually kasi ang parents in denial because sometimes a lot of parents might think it's their fault, yan. But actually, hindi po kasalanan ng parents yun. It's a neurobiological disorder. They're, you know, when you have ADHD, you're born with it and it's a lifetime thing.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing is that, yes, marami pong positive characteristics ng ADHD. As not within ADHD itself when you look at the characteristics, but definitely yung person mismo with ADHD has a lot of positive characteristics. Definitely, I'm sure, for example, if you're hyperactive, let's say you have more energy for the things that you do. You have, for example, Michael Phelps, who's, diba, you know, an Olympic champion swimmer. Na-attribute niya sa ADHD niya yung energy levels niya. Okay. Usually able to perform consistently.
Okay.
You know, and since, you know, you have, ano, you also find a lot of ADHD individuals which are very creative. That's very true for Mr. Peggy. Parag-usap kami things. Yeah. Very creative, you know, very, very philosophical pagka-usap mo siya. You know, kasi we all, lagi kami magkasama nowadays and it's you get to learn a lot, not just from talking.
Intelligent, no?
Yes,
very intelligent. Yeah. Actually,
your son, you have that experience, I guess, with your son.
Actually, yung problema niya, alam niya na yung subject niya, kaya inaalisan niya na. Kasi alam mo na, gano'n, di ba? Di ba? Gano'n ka rin.
Oh yeah, gano'n siya.
Aalamin natin, doctor, kasi yung experience po. Maganda kasi may kasama tayong anak, siya yung nakaka-experience mismo. At nanay, kasi challenging yung pinagdaanan ko sa pagkakaroon and not believing na may ADHD yung aking anak until the age of 16 na siya. That's when I started realizing, yes. Ikaw ba growing up, did you have a problem with your parents? Kasi hindi ka nila maintindihan, ba't ang kulit-kulit mo? Tsaka bakit hindi ka di ba, hindi sila mapakali sa isang pwesto eh. Yan ang problema nila.
I think I had more problems with adults outside of my family because my family was also pretty much hyperactive.
So jive lang kayo, jive lang kayo. Pero you, when you mentioned difficulty, what kind of difficulty were you able to encounter?
Well, I would, since I was fidgety or sometimes I would be too loud in class,
Colette.
it would be a bother to the other students or to the other to my classmates.
Lagi rin pinapatawag yung nanay mo ng counselor. Lagi rin ba ang nanay mo ang nasa school dahil pinapatawag?
Medyo. Pero I guess it was more because I wasn't finishing my work at in time.
Hindi dahil marami kang ginagawang makabuluhan.
It was more because I wasn't finishing my work. So,
iba-iba din,
So inattentive siya. Sa akin siguro mas more hyperactive. Ang kulit kasi talaga sobra. Pero now let's talk about the feeling naman of parents because it's really frustrating. Kasi they're very sweet, they're very loving, they're very kind. Pero they always make mistake and they'll say sorry. Tapos mamaya gagawin mo ulit. So lagi kami nag-aaway. Kayo po ba natanggap niyo yun? And how are you dealing with it now na 10 years old and 14? That's the hardest at that age, di ba?
Kasi ako, I took as an advantage na I'm a nurse. So, na-recognize ko siya early.
Okay.
Yung husband ko, medyo mas nag-take time to accept. I'm glad na lang dahil kasi hindi siya yung hyperactive type. So, siya yung inattentive type. Pero tama ka, they are very, very sweet. When they make mistakes, really, they will butter you up after. and they are very intelligent kasi most of them really have IQ above average.
Do you have good relationship with them now?
Yes naman. No.
Yun kasi ang gusto ko maintindihan ng mga kababayan natin na yung iba kasi na-frustrate sila. Parang feeling nila sobrang salbay. My son was even called demon child before kasi sa sobrang kulit niya. Nakakahiya sa iba. And then when I started to realize anong meron siya, nagkaintindihan kaming dalawa at nagkaintindihan ang lahat ng mga kababayan natin. Let's talk about yung schooling ng mga taong may ADHD, no? Kasi siya, Yuki, no? Meron bang special school for them? Dito sa Pilipinas?
Well, I would say we have specialized schools, no, that have, like for example, I teach in one. It's in Timog. This is Mind Matters Christian Academy.
Okay.
And actually, I have class there in 30 minutes. But, yung...
Ganon?
I do. Okay. Yeah, I'm teaching there in a few minutes. And, when you have specialized schools, no, that's generally not the first option, though. Well, you do have, like for example, I could say this for us, no, we deal with high functioning cases tulad ng ADHD and Asperger syndrome, ganun. The first priority is still to try and put the child in an inclusive environment na tinatawag. Pagsabihin nun, you want the child in a regular classroom, pero may mga tinatawag na accommodations for a person with ADHD. So for instance, I have this one student, for example lang, pwede siya magdala ng tablet sa ano niya, sa school, sa classroom. Why? Because he has a hard time focusing on copying all his homework. So he has to type it doon sa ano niya, sa tablet niya. Bawal nga lang siya mag-internet. So that's an accommodation, no?
Okay.
It didn't really change kung ano yung expectation sa kanya in terms of yung galing niya sa math, galing sa reading, pareho lang. Pero there are certain things that he can do. Also, another very common one is just to allow them to step out, to go inside a, you know, a silent room, ganyan, to refocus, diba, and go back. Ganon. So, okay, certain things like that, that's one of the movements that we're trying to do then as, you know, as an NPO, you know, the ADHD Society of the Philippines. We're trying to advocate for these kinds of, you know, measures para maintindihan ng mga schools na, oh, okay, they can excel in the classroom, but we have to differentiate our instruction para sa kanila.
So that's very good, but do you have that advocacy sa school? Kasi ang problema, second parents ang mga teachers eh.
Yes, yes.
So they should know about this disease.
Definitely.
How do you get to inform them of this disease? Oh, not, it's not a disease actually, it's a disorder, di ba?
Yeah,
di naman
yan
sakit
so,
eh.
Disease
so, meron ba kayong campaign na yung mga teacher kailangan mag-aral and all that?
You know what? You know, sa UP, taking my MA ngayon sa UP, one of the things that we're doing is that, you know, we're trying to campaign for that.
Mm-hmm.
But as part of the ADHD Society, yun, as part of our, you know, NPO or non-profit organization, what we're doing is, you know, we conduct seminars. We call on schools. Actually, this March 1st, we have a seminar sa Kabanatuan. So we're trying to reach outside Metro Manila, you know, to educate the community, the schools, okay, and all the other, you know, all the other parties involved, parents, about it, so that we can start on, you know,
okay,
doing this.
Ito lang, mabilis na explanation, bakit daw may slash ang AD/HD? Kasi dati ADD yan, naging ADHD. Ngayon,
okay,
AD/HD, why is it, sir?
You know what, ako, I'll be honest, I don't know what the slash is for.
Yeah.
But to explain yung difference ng ADD tsaka ADHD, ADD is actually an old term, which refers now to the ADD, attention deficit disorder, nawala yung hyperactivity.
Uh-oh.
Now it's just called ADHD, inattentive type.
Uh-oh.
So pareho interchangeable.
Pero the same lang yan.
Uh-oh.
Okay, at mga kasambahay, ang dami talaga natin mga information na gustong malaman patungkol po sa sakit na ADHD. Kung paano madadiagnose ang ating mga anak, importante po yan, ano? Para malaman natin. May mga activities po kasi kayo naka-line up. Kasi ngayon, itong month na ito, we're celebrating, ano? ADHD Awareness Month. Ano po yung mga...
It's actually in October. But...
October.
Yeah. No, but we have a lot of activities
but
this month. So parang ganun na.
You have an activity on March 1, di ba? This coming March.
Two actually.
Two, okay. What is the activities?
I would like to invite everybody, all parents and teachers, in March 1 at the University Hotel sa University of the Philippines, we're gonna have a special parenting seminar.
Right.
We're gonna have Miss Malu Chongson Ortiz to be our speaker. She's an advocate for children with special needs.
Right. At meron pa rin po silang school caravan, mga kasambahay, ang kanilang team, malikot, makulit, pero matalino. O, di ba? Ayan po, this coming March 1 din po yan, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Thank you so much, no? Sorry, ha, maikli ang ating oras. But anyway, for more information, pwede po kayong tumawag sa 426-8560 or di kaya may website kayo, no?
ADHD Society of the Philippines.
Alright! Salamat po mga kasambahay. Huwag po kayo magpapalit ng channel sapagkat magbabalik muli ang Good Morning, Kuya!